Welcome to episode 1 of Katrina's Disney CRP vlog. Hi everyone, my name is Katrina and I'm from Saskatchewan in Canada. Saskatchewan. I've just been accepted as a cultural representative for Canada for the Disney World Cultural Representative Program. I'll be starting September 14th and going all the way till September 9th the following year. So what I do currently is I'm a nanny during the week. So I'm a part-time nanny, part-time princess. I'm also a singer-actor as well. So I'm a part of a lot of community theater. And I do a lot of singing at my church and with my friends, and my sister and I like to sing together, so I'm sure you can find some songs on my channel also if you want to listen to me singing. I'm going to be working in the attractions area, so basically I'm going to be running videos that talk about Canada and helping out with KidCot in the Epcot Center. So here's my story. So a year ago, when I was just finishing up performing arts school, I applied for the summer program at Disney World, but unfortunately I didn't get the job. But apparently they kept my resume on file. So in January, when I had just returned from a really long trip in the States actually, I received an email from them asking me to come in for an interview for the Disney Cultural Representative Program. Basically, I had to fly from Saskatoon all the way to Vancouver, and that's a pretty far flight. When I got to my interview, we were first invited to a presentation on the program. So two very nice ladies came up to the front and had a video about what we'd be doing and what the program looks like, and made it really exciting. And there was probably about maybe 20 of us in the room. It was in a hotel downtown in Vancouver, and everyone was dressed up pretty fancy. I got the memo that it was business casual, but I think in my head it wasn't as businessy as it should have been. So basically I showed up wearing leggings, a nice shirt, and a cardigan, and some boots. So in between the presentation and my interview, I talked to my mom and told her about this. She said for me to go out and get something to dress up a little bit better for my interview. So I went shopping. I went and I found a nice gray blazer to put over top of my shirt instead of my cardigan. And I got some nice flats to put on instead of my boots. It was really hot anyways though. And I put my hair up so that it was not just dangling down. So just look a little bit more professional. I also had some extra makeup to put on. I already had some in my bag, so that worked for me. And then when I got to the interview, first we sat outside for a little bit, outside of the room, with a group of people, and we were all chatting and stuff, and I was talking to one girl who was from Vancouver, and she was really nice. So when I went into the room, I went to one lady, and there's someone else getting interviewed by another lady at the same time as me, and my lady was really nice, and she was very interested in what I had to offer, and just made it really easy and relaxed. She asked a few questions, nothing really hard. It was all just like, what have you been doing? What do you like to do? What are your preferences for working in Disney World? And I said basically, I'd be willing to do anything, but I put at the top attractions and merchandise. Got to the interview. I used to have really bright red hair. So when I got to the interview, one of the last things the lady asked me, or told me, I guess, was that if I get the job, I'm gonna have to dye my hair. And that's a big deal for me, because I just finished dyeing it a million times. So I've got it to a nice strawberry blonde color now. It took forever. I had a lot of pink going on while I was trying to get it out of the red, and it had been pink for a really long time. There's still little bits of it if you look really hard, but it's mostly blonde now, and it's mostly one color now, which is nice. Then the waiting process happened, and I was waiting and waiting and waiting for a really long time. And then one day I got an email. I was kind of expecting a letter, but I got an email, and I opened it up and it said, "Congratulations, you've been accepted." Now, to begin with, I wasn't sure that I wanted to do this program quite yet, because I had a few different other options I was thinking of doing, so I had to take some time to just kind of think about it. And then when I finally decided that it was going to be a good thing for me, I emailed right away and said that I accept the job offer, and I found out that I'd be working in attractions. Once I'd finished all that, just had to wait. So I'm currently 75 days till Disney. So I'm 75 days till I start working at Disney. I fly out a few days before, so I will be there for maybe 3 days before I start that, just hanging out with a friend that I know out there. So I'm really excited. If you have any questions or anything like that, feel free to comment below. Want to follow my adventures, then I suppose you can subscribe. Yeah, I'm so excited to be starting this journey, and I hope I actually keep up this vlog. I might not. Bye! Thanks for watching!